The following is a Leading the Way special presentation.
Welcome to Cairo, Egypt. As you see from the background, what a special place, especially in my heart. And I'm so glad you joined us. This is going to be a very special program. We celebrated the gospel of Jesus Christ. As a matter of fact, this year we are celebrating the 15th anniversary of Kingdom Set. We've been broadcasting here for 15 years in millions and millions of homes across the world. And so I'm glad you joined us. Stay tuned.
We're going to see thousands of people come, bringing the lost with them. Dr. Michael Youssef is going to proclaim the gospel, give an invitation, and we're praying for a harvest. We're praying for thousands to give their life to Jesus Christ.
When Michael Youssef and his team started to share about this evangelistic campaign coming to Egypt, I was celebrating, because this is a wonderful opportunity and wonderful timing now to call people to repent and come back to the Lord. And we are expecting thousands and thousands to come to Christ.
Thousands of people will be attending the event to return with new hope, new life, real change in their lives. And there will be a radical change to repent for their sins.
I expect today to be a day of harvest for Egypt. The Lord will send great blessings upon Egypt. Despite the difficult things we have been through, the Lord comes in times of hardships.
I watched Dr. Michael Youssef on TV, and I'm amazed. He has come back to Egypt, and Egypt needs him. And we need his prayers.
He gave us some sign about the nearness of his return.
Our dream is that all Egyptians pray to receive Jesus, and that this event is transforming.
We need it, because without the shepherd, the sheep will be scattered. I thank Dr. Michael Youssef.
I pray the Lord will speak through Dr. Michael Youssef, that he may fulfill his ministry around the world, and for his word to reach to the largest number of people.
Thank you for praying for Leading the Way. Thank you for praying for Dr. Youssef and our ministry of the celebrations, that we could continue to bring the gospel around the world, to reach the lost for Jesus and to see a harvest of souls. Thank you for your partnership with Leading the Way.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God.
How great is our God?
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Amen.
محاصك ذنوبي وماضي الأثيم.
عظيم أنا يا إله عظيم أنا يا إله عظيم وبغني بين الناس لي إله عظيم
مساء الخير. I am so honored to be here back in Cairo.
امتياز كبير ان انا موجود مرة تانية هنا في القاهرة.
I'm going to tell you something that is the absolute truth and my wife knows this.
عاوز اقول لكم على حقيقة تقريبا مراتي هي الوحيدة اللي عارفاها.
I've been around the world about 76 times.
انا سافرت في حتت كتير قوي في العالم تقريبا 76 بلد.
I've preached everywhere in the world.
ووعظت تقريبا في كل حتة في العالم.
But it's a very special privilege and honor to be in my home country.
لكن امتياز كبير جدا وشرف كبير ليا ان انا اكون موجود بقى وعظت في بلدي.
تحيا مصر.
تحيا مصر.
The Lord laid this message on my heart several months ago just for you.
الرب وضع هذه الرسالة على قلبي علشان أشاركها معكم أنتوا تحديداً.
Increasingly, religious and non-religious publications are asking the same question.
بشكل متزايد كل المطبوعات والكتابات الدينية وغير الدينية بتسأل نفس السؤال.
Is this the end of the world?
هو دي نهاية العالم؟
Both the religious and the non-religious observers are looking at the current events and they're coming to the same conclusion.
المتدينين وغير المتدينين ايضا بيبصوا كده على الاحداث الجارية ووصلوا لنفس الاستنتاج.
So many global watchers are observing world events and they're coming to the same conclusion.
ناس كتير جدا وهي عمالة تلاحظ الاحداث والحاجات اللي بتجرى في العالم وصلوا لنفس هذا التساؤل والاستنتاج.
But the most important question is this.
لكن اهم سؤال هو ده.
Are you ready for the end of the world?
هل انت مستعد لو دي نهاية العالم؟
Jesus is coming back.
يسوع هيرجع مرة تانية.
And are you ready to meet him on the air?
هل انت مستعد ان انت تقابل يسوع مرة تانية في النهاية؟
Jesus told us that this world as we know it will come to an end.
يسوع قال لنا انه هذا العالم كما نعرفه سوف ينتهي في يوم ما.
Jesus, who holds the future of the world in his hands, gave us some things to look forward to.
يسوع الذي يمسك هذا العالم بين يديه أعطانا شيئا لنعيش من أجله.
He gave us some sign about the nearness of his return.
وهو كمان أعطانا بعض العلامات اللي بتشاور لنا على نهاية العالم.
In Matthew 24 and 25, he gives us some of these signs.
وفي إنجيل متى صح 24 و25 يعطينا بعض هذه العلامات.
Jesus called these signs labor pains.
يسوع قال إنه العلامات دي عاملة زي أوجاع المخاض أو الولادة.
We know when the baby is about to be born.
في ولاد أو أطفال بيتولدوا.
The labor pain increases in frequency and in intensity.
السيدة بتشعر بألم هذا المخاض بشكل متزايد فبتحس إن الولادة قربت.
One of these labor pains is the increase of selfishness.
واحدة من أوجاع المخاض دي هي تزايد روح الأنانية.
Another sign is falsehood and deception.
علامة تانية من العلامات تزايد الخداع.
Another sign he said is the increase in the number of earthquakes and floods and natural catastrophes.
علامة أخرى من العلامات اللي يسوع اتكلم عنها قال إنه هيبقى فيه زلازل وهيبقى فيه فيضانات وهيبقى فيه كوارث طبيعية.
And an increase in the loss of the value of money.
تزايد في تناقص قيمة المال.
Does this sound familiar here in Egypt?
هو بيدي هذه العلامات لنا جميعا.
But then he gives us the greatest sign of all.
لكن بعد كده بيدي علامة تكاد تكون أعظم العلامات.
Here's what Jesus said.
ركز معايا هو ده اللي يسوع بيقوله.
As it was in the days of Noah.
وكما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
كذلك يكون أيضا العلامات قبل مجيء ابن الإنسان.
For the days before the flood.
لأنه كما كانوا في الأيام التي قبل الطوفان.
People were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage.
يأكلون ويشربون ويتزوجون ويزوجون.
Up to the day Noah entered the ark.
إلى اليوم الذي دخل فيه نوح الفلك.
and they knew nothing about what is going to happen.
ولم يعلموا أي شيء عن إلا يحصل.
Until the flood came and swept them all away.
إلى أن جاء الطوفان وأخذ الجميع.
Jesus said.
يسوع بيقول.
This is how it will be in the coming of the Son of Man.
بيقول ده شكل الدنيا قبل وقت مجيء ابن الإنسان.
Question.
سؤال.
What those days of Noah like?
يا ترى أيام نوح دي كان شكلها إيه يعني؟
God tells us in His Word.
الحقيقة في كلمة الله، الله بيحكي لنا عن أيام نوح كان شكلها إيه.
There were days of loss of morality.
كان في الأيام دي في فقدان للأخلاقيات.
There was an increase in hatred and lust and bloodshed.
كان في تزايد في الكراهية وفي الشهوة وفي سفك الدماء.
There is an increase in moral depravity.
كان في تزايد في الانهيار الأخلاقي.
Let's look at the word of God in Genesis chapter 6 and see those days of Noah.
خلونا نبص على كلمة الله ماذا تقول في تكوين أصحاح 6 عن أيام نوح.
Chapter 6 verse 5.
أصحاح تكوين أصحاح 6 آية 5.
The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race has become.
ورأى الرب أن شر الإنسان قد كثر في الأرض.
That every inclination of thought and only evil all the time.
وأن كل تصور أفكار قلبه إنما هو شرير كل يوم.
In 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 3.
في بطرس الثانية أصحاح 3 وآية 3.
He tells us about the last days.
بيحكي لنا الكتاب عن الأيام الأخيرة.
Scoffers will be saying, "Where is this day of the return of Christ?"
بيقول سيأتي في آخر الأيام مستهزئون قائلين أين هو موعد مجيئه؟
They have been saying this since for many years.
هم عمالين يقولوا إنه هيرجع بقالهم سنين طويلة.
Yet all these signs that the Lord Jesus Christ gave us are in place right now.
لكن الحقيقة إنه كل العلامات اللي الرب يسوع أعطاها لنا موجودة في الوقت الحالي.
As I view what's happening in the world.
وأنا ببص على الأحداث اللي بتحصل حول العالم.
I see some people in the grip of fear.
أنا شايف إنه ناس واقعة في قبضة الخوف.
But those who have placed their whole faith and trust in Jesus Christ as their only Savior and Lord need not fear.
لكن الناس اللي وضعت ثقتها وإيمانها بالكامل في يسوع المسيح من أجل خلاصهم لا يحتاجون إلى أن يخافوا.
In fact, we look forward to that day.
الحقيقة إحنا بنتطلع بشوق إلى هذا اليوم.
Because Jesus is our Savior.
لأنه يسوع هو مخلصنا.
Therefore, that day is a day of rejoicing.
وعشان كده هذا اليوم اللي هو يوم عودته سيكون يوم فرح.
The Bible said.
بيقول الكتاب المقدس.
Therefore, there is no condemnation upon those who are in Christ Jesus.
لأنه لا شيء من الدينونة على الذين هم في المسيح يسوع.
And when you place your whole trust in Him.
والنهاردة خليني أحط سؤال مقدس جدا قدامك.
You will have no fear.
ساعة لما تواجه هذا الأمر لن يكون لديك في
you will have no anxiety.
لن يكون لديك قلق.
You will have no worries.
لن يكون عندك قلق.
In fact, the opposite is true.
الحقيقة العكس بتاع كل ده.
You will have peace in the midst of the world's turmoil.
هيكون عندك سلام في وسط الضيقات والأحداث اللي حصلت في العالم.
You will have joy in the midst of the world's sorrow.
هيكون عندك فرح في وسط الحزن اللي بيرمي عليك العالم.
As it was in the days of Noah.
كما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be in the days prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
هكذا سيكون في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
Let's look closely at the days of Noah.
هو خد بالك خلونا نبص كده عن قرب لإيه اللي كان بيحصل أيام نوح.
Jesus said in Matthew 24:38.
في إنجيل متى 24:38 يسوع قال كده.
The days before the flood came and swept them away.
الأيام اللي كانت قبل الطوفان كانت بهذا الشكل بالضبط. مسحت كل حاجة.
They were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage.
كانوا بيأكلوا ويشربوا ويتزوجوا ويزوجوا.
They were oblivious to the coming danger.
لكن الحقيقة أنهم كانوا غافلين تماماً عن الخطر القادم.
Until the flood came and swept them away.
إلى أن جاء الطوفان ومسحهم كلهم من على وجه الأرض.
That's how going to be at the end times.
وهذا هو ما سيحدث في نهاية الزمان.
But there's something else that is so disturbing about the last days in which we live right now.
لكن هناك شيء آخر مزعج جداً بشأن الأيام الأخيرة التي نعيش فيها اليوم.
In the days of Noah, they just lost their physical lives.
في أيام نوح هم خسروا بس حياتهم البدنية أو الجسدية.
But in the coming judgment,
لكن في الدينونة الآتية
there's going to be an eternity in suffering and torment.
سيكون هناك أبدية سيقضيها البعض في العذاب.
And that is why it is very important that if you do not know Jesus as your only savior, you do that tonight.
وعلشان كده مهم جدا ان انت تركز وتختار تقبل يسوع كمخلصك الشخصي النهاردة.
In the New Testament, the Apostle Peter tells us.
في العهد الجديد الرسول بطرس بيقول لنا كده.
In 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 5.
في بطرس الثانية الأصحاح الثاني وآية 5.
For God did not spare the ancient world.
بيقول إنه الله لم يشفق على العالم القديم.
When he brought the flood unto its ungodly people.
إذ جلب طوفانا على عالم الفجار.
Oh, but listen to this part.
عاوزك تركز وتسمع الجملة دي كويس قوي.
But he protected Noah.
لكن هو حفظ نوحا.
Why?
ليه؟
Because he was a preacher of righteousness.
لأن هو كان كارزا للبر.
The apostle Peter continues.
وده بيكمل الرسول بطرس هنا بيقول كده.
The Lord knows how to rescue the godly from trials.
يعلم الرب أن ينقذ الأتقياء من التجربة.
And God can deliver you tonight.
والله يقدر ينقذك ويخلصك الليلة.
If you come to him and ask for his deliverance, he will deliver you no matter where you are.
إذا أتيت له وطلبت أن يخلصك سوف يخلصك بغض النظر عن مكانك.
When you place your whole trust in Jesus Christ.
أنت محتاج تحط ثقتك بالكامل في الرب يسوع.
He will set you free.
وهو هيحررك.
When you receive him as Lord.
لما تستقبل يسوع كمخلص وسيد.
When you obey his word.
عندما تطيع كلمته.
When you love him with all your heart.
عندما تحبه بكل قلبك.
He will protect you from danger.
هو سيحميك من الخطر.
That danger that is awaiting the whole world.
المخاطر اللي بتحيق بهذا العالم كله.
I pray tonight.
لكن بصلي النهاردة.
That no one at the sound of my voice anywhere in the world.
إنه ما فيش أي حد بيسمع هذه الرسالة في أي مكان.
Would ignore the call of God on you to turn around and come to Him.
يتجاهل دعوة الله ليك اللي بتقول لك لف وارجع لي.
The Bible said.
الكتاب المقدس بيقول كده.
Today, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart.
اليوم إن سمعتم صوته لا تقسوا قلوبكم.
Please listen carefully.
ركز معايا كويس أوي.
God is calling you.
الله بيدعوك.
He's calling you to escape from sin and guilt.
بيدعوك لأن تهرب من الخطية.
He wants to deliver you from addictions and depression.
يريد أن يخلصك من إدمانات بتقيدك.
God wants to set you free from fear and anxiety.
عاوز يحررك من الخوف ومن القلق.
God is calling you, and that's why you're here tonight.
الله بيدعوك وعشان كده انت موجود هنا الليلة.
He's calling you for peace and he's calling you for joy in this life.
هو بيدعوك النهاردة للفرح وللسلام.
And they can only be found in Jesus alone.
ودي الحاجات اللي ما تقدرش تلاقيها غير في الرب يسوع وحده.
God wants to assure you that you can spend eternity with Jesus in heaven.
الله عاوز يأكد لك انك تقدر تقضي الأبدية بتاعتك مع يسوع في السماء.
Someone here may say,
يمكن حد هنا سمعني كده بيقول
when things really get bad I'm gonna get right with God.
يعني لما الأمور في حياتي وظروف بقى تبقى صعبة قوي أنا هبتدي أفكر في حكاية ربنا دي.
My friend, this could be your last chance to hear this invitation and respond to it.
صديقي عايز أقول لك إنه قد تكون هذه فرصتك الأخيرة لسماع رسالة الإنجيل فتجاوب معها.
You may never get another chance.
يمكن ما يبقاش عندك فرصة تاني تسمع فيها الرسالة.
Today is the day of salvation.
النهاردة يوم الخلاص.
Harden not your heart.
لا تقسي قلبك.
I'm here to tell you tonight that you can be assured of heaven now.
والنهاردة أنا موجود علشان أقول لك إنك تقدر يبقى عندك يقين إنك رايح السماء دلوقتي.
Will you respond to his invitation?
لكن هل ستتجاوب مع هذه الدعوة?
Will you come surrendering to him?
هل هتيجي وتسلم كل شيء لي؟
You will never be the same.
لما تعمل كده مش هتبقى زي ما كنت هتتغير.
Would you bow your heads with me in prayer, please?
خلونا نحني رؤوسنا في الصلاة.
I don't know where you are.
أنا مش عارف أنت فين.
But you know where you are.
لكن أنت عارف أنت فين.
You could be in a far country.
يمكن تكون في دولة بعيدة.
Or you could be so close but not close enough.
لكن ممكن تكون كمان قريب لكن مش قريب من المسيح بما فيه الكفاية.
No doubt you are hearing many voices right now.
ما فيش شك إن أنت دلوقتي بتسمع أصوات كتيرة في ذهنك.
The Holy Spirit is saying to you, respond tonight.
لكن الروح القدس بيهمس لقلبك ويقول لك تجاوب مع الرسالة اللي سمعتها الليلة.
But Satan is saying, not yet.
الشيطان بيقول لك لا مش لازم دلوقتي.
You got a lot of living to do.
أنت مازال قدامك حياة طويلة.
Who can guarantee the next minute?
لكن مين يقدر يضمن إنه يفضل عايش دقيقة تانية?
And so say to the Lord.
قول للرب دلوقتي.
Lord, I'm here today.
يا رب أنا هنا النهاردة.
To give you my life.
عشان أدي لك حياتي.
To receive you as my only Savior and Lord.
علشان أقبلك كرب ومخلص لحياتي.
To obey you for the rest of my life.
لأطيعك لباقي أيامي.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
It felt like the Lord's presence was everywhere, touching almost everyone.
When they heard the message, many were changed.
I feel like the message tonight was for everyone in this generation.
This evening was genuinely beautiful, and I hope it happens over and over again.
I feel that Dr. Michael Youssef can convey information in a simple, smooth, and beautiful way. Even though I'm young, I can understand Dr. Youssef's message as spiritual nourishment. While walking among the people, I asked them, "Do you want to accept Christ as your Savior?" What really made a difference for me is that everyone was saying, "Yes, I wish to surrender my life to Christ."
I found youth of all ages crying and praying from the bottom of their hearts. I have never seen something like this before.
Been watching Leading the Way in Egypt, a Leading the Way evangelistic celebration from the heart of Cairo. Thank you for joining us today for this special presentation of Leading the Way with Dr. Michael Youssef.
All over the globe, Leading the Way is proclaiming the life-changing truth of the gospel through every available means. One of our key ministries in that effort is the Kingdom Set, our 24/7 satellite television channel broadcasting across the world. Reaching into over 260 million homes in dozens of the hardest to reach countries on earth, the Kingdom Set is a lifeline of truth in a world of darkness.
God began to speak in my spirit again. You need to come up with a station that is going to broadcast the gospel unapologetically, lovingly, truthfully.
Launched by Dr. Michael Youssef, the Kingdom Set is uniquely positioned to spread the good news by being a fusion of the West and the East. Solid biblical teaching from pastors here at home alongside local indigenous Arabic programs that can speak directly to the heart of their people. And God is doing the impossible.
I believe and I feel God is bringing the gospel back to this country, especially to the community around us.
In addition to 24/7 broadcasts, the Kingdom Set utilizes biblically trained follow-up teams on the ground in the region. These dedicated teams encourage viewers, lead the lost to Christ, connect them with local churches, and even plant underground churches where they do not exist.
I consider the Kingdom Set as my church, and the field team is my family.
As you stand with Leading the Way to proclaim the gospel, God is bringing in the harvest, touching lives in some of the darkest parts of the world. Through the Kingdom Set, Leading the Way is uniquely positioned to proclaim the uncompromising truth of Christ across the world. Contact us today to find out how you can get involved in the global work of Leading the Way. Leading the Way with Dr. Michael Youssef is traveling to Mexico for a once-in-a-lifetime revival event. This April, Dr. Youssef will proclaim the good news of Jesus at a 7,000-seat outdoor venue in the heart of Veracruz, Mexico. This historic event will be the first citywide evangelistic campaign in Veracruz in 20 years, so your help in lifting this event up in prayer is essential. This multi-day event will also feature a separate children's event where the life-saving truth of Jesus will be provided to the children of Veracruz. Dr. Youssef's message will also be streamed live on Leading the Way's streaming platforms, so you can take part of it as well. Through your partnership with Leading the Way, God is moving mightily and new believers are coming to know Christ by the multitudes. To find out how you can be a part of this move of God in Mexico, contact us today. Passionately proclaiming uncompromising truth, Leading the Way with Dr. Michael Youssef thanks you for your faithful support through your continued prayers and gifts. You've been watching a special Leading the Way presentation.